Zestiria. When we last left off, we entered the Shrine of Mourning of Lafey here, and we need to start going through and figure out why Asura went bad. And I'm not entirely sure on how that name is pronounced. There's so many.
What are those things? They look like eyes!
That's because they are eyes. I didn't realize arts like this were still alive.
Anyways, I was trying to say the name has been said so many different ways in so many different games, I'm not really sure what is actually proper. So that sent us back to start. Apparently we're not supposed to go left. Okay, I get it now. If only there were some way we could stealth by them, you know. Hit them in such a way they'd never see it coming.
Is this the diary of a shepherd?
A swordsmith suddenly visited by a seraph.
No, crud, did I interrupt it? Maybe. Not sure I can make it all the way over here before. So we either have to do something about those eyes or Mikleo's ability needs a glove. And as crappy as it's been so far, I'm definitely in favor of the front. What happened? Here, see what this does.
Shepherd's diary?
Looks like it.
Creepy eyeball things.
We can rest for a bit.
It'd be a miracle if they had been working. These date all the way back to the Temperance of Everost.
Here we go again. In English, that means...
really
old. So, the era known as the Temperance of Everost was when seraphic civilization reached its peak.
A great many buildings and artifacts from those times were crafted using the power of seraphic arts.
So, the era of wiggy magic everywhere, basically. We're talking ages and ages ago?
Yeah, older than even Edna.
Saray.
Yow!
It's thought that the Temperance preceded the era of the gods, but not a great deal is known for certain. Many vital records were lost during the age known as the Dark Period.
But these Shrines of Trials have preserved relics of things that could only have been made by Seraphim. They're precious evidence that the Temperance of Everost really and truly happened.
Even a bunch of weird-ass eyeballs can be a treasure if you've got the right mindset, huh?
Yeah. You can't fathom the true meaning of legends until you've seen their history with your own eyes. So to speak.
Ha! You look just like Maven when you say that.
Indeed. The face of a hopeless romantic.
A charitable way to say naive simpleton.
You.
Stop it.
There might be something nearby.
Fatigue. I'm gonna walk across, see if there's some way I can maybe disable something. there.
Seems there's a treasure chest near us.
I don't see it. Snow God of Dead Worlds and watches forever upon the world. I can stop neither disaster nor war. I'm the shepherd, yet I'm still weak. I need greater power if I'm to vanquish this malevolence once and for all.
Why is a shepherd's diary in a place like this?
Can't be a coincidence.
A dangerous headspace.
What did you expect?
The job takes its toll. This time there isn't even a marker. Anyway, we'll head over here.
So wait, yeah, look around you.
There's even a teleport here. Raspberry Moose. Toss this in the Accurizer, I think. Basically, it has to go in someone's, because this one is in a really, really bad spot. Okay, stealth. Now I need this to pop.
There might be something nearby.
Every which way. Whoever built this shrine's a real piece of work.
I concur.
Such meticulous design. He or she must have labored very diligently.
I'm gonna break their fingers.
Correction. You're a real piece of work.
This diary be...
Long story short, it's a resounding no. can disable the eyes, that one is a dead end. On both sides. You have to stealth to get through this.
Do you think Maltran came here as well? Even if she did, it wouldn't do her any good.
Only the Shepherd has what it takes to get anywhere in a place like this.
A Shepherd, or his antithesis.
Okay, which one's this one's Ray's house?
Hey, you think Asura is really a Hellion?
Yes, I can feel its malevolence and domain.
Why, do you think it's a fake or something?
I mean, isn't it kind of strange? Why would they let a dangerous Hellion like that roam around freely?
Because they can't stop it.
Why would a protector seraph just leave it be?
Yeah, they're supposed to be powerful, high-ranked seraphim, right?
It probably has to do with the trial. Protector seraphim are given special tasks.
Sounds like a pretty convenient excuse.
Yeah, I can't say that it isn't.
You don't have to put it that way.
Just say they're lazy.
You should know, too. Seraphim aren't exactly models of virtue.
They're not exactly heroes of justice, either.
Well, that's...
Sold! You two sure sound so convincing when you team up.
As long as you got the gist.
Yep. If that's the trial, I'm up for it.
It looks like only her lip syncing is off, and I don't know why. Okay, so... Great hall. I'm dropping to save once again just so I can not worry about the skirt. Pizza delivery.
Give it back!
Is that Asura?
Six arms for not being able to contest strength.
This isn't it either! Where is it? Where is my sword?
His sword?
Is it normal for Hellions to attack each other? Ah!
The big bad seem to be the
lessers. It is my job to defeat the Hellions!
So, Asura is a shepherd. A shepherd who became a Hellion.
Give it back. Give me my sword back!
Okay, weak to earth, level 43, 20,000 hit points. It's armored.
Multiple times? You!
It's not
you
bad
stole my sword, didn't you?
Asura is a Hellion of anger. The cause of his anger ought to be what made him a Hellion.
You mean because his sword was stolen?
No. There's more to it.
Tiger Blade!
Vermilion! Dragon Blade!
Sword!
So yeah, the number was kind of big there at 3,000, but the bad news is... this behavior changes as you get older, just like every other boss we've encountered up until this point. And I'll swap my party.
Give me my sword back, so that I may purify everything!
Asura, you have to focus, Ray. Bring him down with all your strength!
Moment to get some healing.
Yeah! Leap back! Let's go! Sword Ray!
Sadly, yeah. The way the fusion works, that means... Now that I think about it, I think there is a way to actually get a partner slot on their server without having to take control.
What does he want to do? Cut down the whole world? That's the reason why Asura became a Hellion.
Correct.
That voice!
This is the spiritual power of water!
So I'm trying to keep an eye on this. And I need to but unfortunately that revived Lailah, so that means she can go down once again. Well, let me fuse it. Neglected a status ailment victim? Like a teammate? 8, maybe? Give me 3 KOs, yeah. Great system sucks. Cleo's denied all of the XP, but it doesn't really matter. We got the Blessing Orb, which I don't know what that does.
Back! Out all!
He's trying to say something.
Scripted battles suck.
My sword back! Altul!
Altul?
He's gone.
He was the shepherd long ago. Even if he was purified, his body is already deteriorated.
So his rage alone kept him going.
The problem is Altul. Do you think that he stole Asura's sword?
Let's go back and get the story from him straight.
So, Aqualimit, proof of spiritual power.
Why don't we take a rest and eat some snacks?
Asura really was the shepherd, then that makes Altul.
Yes, he was likely the seraph who formed a pact with Asura.
Just like everyone else has with me.
So I probably could have saved Mikleo if not for the scripted reset. Some aspects here are so care here, because odds are we have to come back here. Case in point.
We've defeated Asura.
Much appreciated.
Are you who we think you are?
It is as you suspect. I am the seraph who guided Asura to the way of the shepherd and used him as a vessel.
You stole his sword?
I did.
This is something special.
You can tell with one look.
This sword is made from a rare metal called Mithril. It truly does have enough power to cleave the world.
Is that why you stole it and hid it?
And the whole black aura, perhaps?
Yes. I was probably the one he wanted to slay most of all. But I had no choice. He was pure to the core, and it was that shining purity that tore him apart with worry, and eventually cost him his very soul.
That's why he made that sword, to cut down anything that would be corrupted by malevolence.
But I have no qualms about giving this sword to you. If you can learn to use it, it might aid you even more than the spiritual powers.
Don't touch that damn thing, man.
I'll pass. I already got a sword anyways.
Well said.
So you passed the trial of the spirit as well.
If you don't need it, I'll take it off your hands.
Meltran has arrived.
We were meant for each other. My blade and I shall cleave the world.
Meltran?
Saray, look closely!
No way! She's...
a Hellion!
I apologize for ignoring you back then, Seraphim.
So you really could see us?
What do you intend with the sword? I shall cut down the world, just as Asura wished.
But why?
I should be asking you. Why don't you understand how Asura felt? Were we to erase this corrupted, chaotic world and all the humans in it, would that not rid us of malevolence once and for all? That is the clean, elegant logic of my master, the Lord of Calamity.
You're siding with him?
If Alicia knew about this...
how sad she'd be. Boo-hoo.
You've been using Alicia this whole time.
Ironically enough, to start a war, it is most effective to take a starry-eyed pacifist and get them all riled up over something. But now, everything is lined up for an all-out collision between Highland and Rollins. Our sad princess has outlived her usefulness!
This can't be...
Well... this is a fine pickle, isn't it?
Should guard that sword better, dude.
For a shepherd, I suppose reality is a far crueler trial than anything we could come up with.
Mikleo, Saray seems off lately.
I think he's worried about Alicia. I wish it were as simple as telling him to stop.
True. I'm not sure there's anything we can do.
So, I don't think I got all the loot here, but to be completely honest, I just don't give a damn anymore. This is one of those sucky dungeons that makes it on the worst dungeons.
I'm worried about Alicia too, Saray, but she'll be fine.
I agree. In any case, we have the spiritual power.
And Maltran is connected to the Lord of Calamity. If we stay focused on our goal, I'm sure we'll find a solution.
Right.
So the last two trials are Woosh and Badonk.
Is that supposed to mean wind and earth?
What else would it mean?
Right, silly me.
I don't know where I'm supposed to go. I kind of want to go to Lightning Lake and see if we can check it out on Misha and maybe learn something over there. Chest over here.
It seems there's a treasure chest near us.
Amber boots, those are no good.
Maltran do this?
There are Hellions in the Rollins Imperial family. It isn't all that strange to imagine Hellions amongst the Knights of Highland as well.
A hero in war is a Hellion in life, goes the theory. I guess we have more evidence for that now.
But who would agree with the thoughts of the Lord of Calamity?
It isn't really as strange as you make it sound. Asura himself was a shepherd, as you know.
And he thought the same way.
In order to save the people, and to begin anew, he would destroy everything. It's a pitfall that can trap all humans who let malevolence get the best of them.
Yes.
How am I gonna break it to Alicia?
Does she really need to know?
It might be worse for her not to find out at this point.
But Maltran said she no longer had any use for Alicia.
I suppose we ought to believe her. It wouldn't make sense for her to reveal her true self to us otherwise.
Seems to me the biggest issue is she'd been Alicia's rock through all this chaos, right?
Good point. If Alicia finds that out, not only has she lost her one pillar of support, but that pillar's been using her the entire time. She could fall apart.
That might be exactly what Maltran wants.
She's probably thinking she can get the war rolling for good by crushing Alicia's spirit.
What should I do?
Okay, we're at that just putting in another break right over there. The wind step should pick up as we go, and her house isn't that far. One thing I have to worry about that is just more scenes of side quests. And from that loading screen, I'm expecting there are actual scenes. Seen any blue dots, so we're just going straight to Alicia's.
What
Highland is moving closer to war day by day. No one will listen to me, no matter what I do.
Because you've been digging a hole, girl. You're stubborn as a mule, but even so...
I won't give up. The strength of a knight exists to protect, and their kindness serves the people.
You never change.
Saray, how are the ruins in Lake Haven Heights?
Well, you know, I did obtain the spiritual powers.
Wonderful. Though it's a shame. You just missed meeting my master.
Not really.
Alicia, I needed to tell you about...
Maltran taught me the way of the spirit at a young age. When I train with my master, I feel so invigorated. I don't enjoy all the scratches I get, but it's only because I lack experience.
What kind of person is she?
Well, she's kind of like... like a mother to me. But she doesn't like me saying that, says she's too young. But she taught me martial arts and the way of the knighthood when my mother died. I was only 7. I owe her much.
Alicia...
though, I fear I rely on her a bit too much.
That's not true.
I'll try to convince the Chancellors. I do everything I can.
Are you sure you don't want to tell Alicia the truth about me?
Well, at least you have a sparkling personality.
You really are a pillar of support for her, you know?
That's it? You decided not to tell her just because of that? You're weak, as both a knight and a shepherd.
Ouch.
She's of no use to you now, right? Why don't you just leave her alone?
I'm interested, that's all. Of what will become of the foolish princess, who would needlessly turn herself into a martyr for her country.
That looks kind of nice there.
I know Alicia will see it through.
Do you really think so?
I...
you really don't, do you? After all, you don't even think she has the strength to withstand the truth about me.
Shut up! As long as we take care of it before she knows, everything will be just fine.
No need to rush. The tables will turn soon enough. All is according to his plan.
Yeah, I never really noticed the light and everything.
Are we not able to tell Alicia the truth about Maltran? Because we can't actually believe in Alicia, even when we really want to?
She's just trying to provoke you.
Let's keep it a secret.
Are you sure?
Yeah,
I agree. It appears harming Alicia is not part of her grand plan anyways.
Then I have no objections.
Rose, you agree too, right?
You sure told her off.
Saray looked like he was done with her, so I just took it from there after she started talking smack.
To be honest... I'm scared to tell Alicia the truth about her master.
Alicia really trusts Maltran, more than any one of us can imagine.
Do whatever you want. But if you do face off with her, don't hold back. Otherwise, you'll die.
Yeah, I know.
Don't get so serious. It'll be fine. Come on, stay psyched up!
Right.
Spiritual powers, we have to find those remaining two places. I'm going to go to the inn. If there are any final skits, I'll play those, but I'm going to bring them in and go somewhere else next time for closer to the next of the temples. trying to think of who the next one might be dedicated to. I think the middle sibling is more of a boss or something like that. And I don't know who the fourth one would be unless it's for Arthur himself.
Being a princess sure sounds rough.
Nations and politics are like an entwined spiderweb full of people's desires. If you are too full of ideals, you'll be entangled in the web instantly.
But still, I don't want to say that Alicia's completely wrong.
Especially since we know the reason why she's been working so hard.
In times like these, Alicia's straightforwardness is a truly valuable asset. However, a sword that is too hard can break easily.
True, and besides, Alicia does make sound arguments.
Isn't that a good thing?
It's like, you know how if someone pointed out your wrongdoings, it really hits you? You'd probably get discouraged, or even snap.
They're only human, after all.
Meaning that by pushing her sharp reasoning on others, it causes cognitive dissonance and turns people against her. So that's it.
Even though she's right, she's met with hostility. And she faces her challenger straight on, which in turn only brings forth even more hostility.
So that's why she worries so.
What a pain.
I'm sure it's tough on her.
However, I don't think Alicia's feelings are completely misguided. Though we may need to assess the situation to know for sure.
Alicia isn't the only one. I need to see for myself as well.
Okay, is there another scout? Okay, I'm putting the brake here. I'm just really worn out after that freaking dungeon. I couldn't find all the loot. I'm hoping that nothing there is really worthwhile. I got the one cheagle thing. So I'm just hoping that's good enough. Anyway, wrapping things up here. I'm the Hero of Light. Thanks for watching, and goodbye.